And if you're just joining us, you're watching a live view of Dragon successfully disconnecting from the second stage, heading to the International Space Station. This is the 27th commercial resupply mission to the International Space Station for NASA. This is SpaceX's 17th mission this year and second Dragon flight to station for 2023. We lifted off about 12 minutes and 23 seconds ago from Kennedy Space Center at Historic Launch Complex 39A. And there you can see Dragon slowly drifting away from the second stage. The next milestone coming up is the nose cone opening sequence, which protects the docking ring and navigation sensors. And that's going to do it for me here in Hawthorne, so I'm going to throw it back over to Dan in Houston.
Hey, thank you so much, Zach, and hello everyone once again from Mission Control Houston. Great to see another Dragon on orbit. You've got a happy team here in Mission Control, and we'll have a happy crew of 7 astronauts and cosmonauts on board the space station when they wake up tomorrow with Dragon now on its way. As Zach said, the next milestone that we're going to be keeping an eye out for is going to be the nose cone open. This takes a couple of minutes, and that's to open the nose cone. So it's exactly what it sounds like. It's at the very top or the nose part of Dragon, and that's going to slowly open up to reveal a couple of different components. That nose cone stays closed during the flight up to orbit just to protect some of those more sensitive instruments from the thermal and aerodynamic loads that Dragon's experiencing on its ride uphill. Once it opens up, we're going to be revealing a couple of different things, including some propulsion elements, primarily 4 forward bulkhead Draco thrusters. Those are the primary thrusters that Dragon is going to be using for its major delta velocity burn. So those are just firings of the engines to gradually raise its orbit as it gets closer and closer to the space station. It's also going to reveal a suite of navigation equipment. Dragon has a couple of different methods to essentially find its way through outer space. And underneath the nose cone, there is something called the Dragon Eye Star Trackers. And then it will also be pairing that with an inertial measurement unit and GPS sensors. All of these kind of working in tandem to essentially tell Dragon where it is in outer space and where it needs to head. We also do what's called a state vector upload to the spacecraft just prior to launch, telling it where space station is. And then once it gets closer, we'll have what's called relative GPS systems that will be able to talk to each other between Dragon and space station, just as they're essentially, they start talking to each other, let them know where they are. And those come really in handy when we start getting into the integrated operations, which you're going to be seeing a lot more of this room once we arrive on Thursday morning, as when we're in integrated operations, you've got a team here in Houston and a team out in Hawthorne that are working to bring us Dragon in. But we are getting closer to that nose cone to start opening. There are 12 hooks around the docking ring of the Dragon spacecraft. 6 of those are actually holding the nose cone in place during the launch. All 12 are closed when we're launching, and we open them up. If you've watched any of the previous crew missions or even the cargo missions, we do them in 2 different sets, 2 sets of 6. So 1 set already open, the second set opening now. And once that second set is open, the nose cone will start to deploy. Again, it takes a couple of minutes for that nose cone to open, usually about 5 minutes or so. And then it'll gradually open. It swings open a little more than about 110 degrees. So that gives Dragon plenty of clearance to dock with the space station, as this is going to reveal also the docking ring. And that's what Dragon's going to be using to actually dock with the International Docking Adapter on board the station. Again, we're heading to the forward port. We have 2 of those on the U.S. segment right now with the docking adapters, the forward port and the Zenith, or the space-facing port on Node 2, the Harmony module. And this Dragon is going to be bound for the forward port. It was just left vacant by the Crew Dragon Endurance, which brought Crew 5 home over the weekend after 157 days in space. And this Dragon is bound for that one to kick off really about a month and change of really intense cargo and science operations. But at this moment in time, 1 set of hooks open. We're still waiting for that second set of 6 to open up. And then once that happens, the nose cone will start to deploy. Shortly after that, we'll do checkouts of those forward bulkhead Dracos, those 4 Dracos that are hiding underneath the nose cone right now. And once those are checked out, we'll be pretty much ready to go. And as Dragon will start to do its different phasing burns to get to the space station. Sounds like we've got all six of the second set are now open and just standing by, and it looks like the nose cone has started to deploy. So again, this is going to kick off a couple of minutes for the nose cone to fully open, but all hooks are open and the nose cone is deploying. While we wait for the nose cone to open, I do want to bring in, we have a guest real quickly. We have Phil Dempsey. He's the manager of the Vehicle Integration Office in NASA's International Space Station Program, basically the guy overseeing all the different spacecraft responsible for bringing crew and cargo up to the space station. Phil, first, thanks so much for joining me. Just want to get your thoughts real quick. Walk us through, you know, we've got another Dragon mission heading to the station. What's this going to mean for those crew members on board?
Hey, yeah, thanks. So first of all, just saw a really great launch from our SpaceX team down here in Florida. You know, getting a new Dragon is really exciting for the crew for a couple of reasons. You know, first, like you just kind of mentioned, these cargo missions are really action-packed times for the crew. You know, it starts when they dock Thursday morning. We're just getting into the vehicle, getting critical research out and into its location on the ISS. You know, then the crew does some standard cargo ops and payload moves across this 30-day mission. But while they're doing that, they're also doing critical research that actually has to be completed during the dock mission in order to get those results back down on that same vehicle when it comes down a little over 30 days after it goes up. Then it's time to get it repacked with hardware. Additionally, these cargo missions are the few chances we have to get fresh or refrigerated food up to the crew. So, you know, we give them a little taste of home. They've got some fresh fruit and cheeses on this one.
And I know they're asleep, but I think they're going to be pretty excited when they wake up. We actually have some live views now of the nose cone opening. We're about halfway through. But Phil, before I let you go, just general feelings from you, the program. This has been just another incredibly busy spring. It feels like we're always in the busy season with Station. We just brought a crew home over the weekend after launching another one. What's it been like to just balance all of the traffic coming and going from the space station?
Yeah, you know, it seems like we're partway through and there's a lot going on. It is really exciting. You know, as for the pace, most of us probably wouldn't have it any other way, I'll tell you. You know, we're in our third decade of operating this orbiting research facility, and these are the crew and cargo missions to keep it going. But if you look ahead, add it into that mix, you know, we got an upcoming Boeing first crewed flight. We've got a second private astronaut mission. So while busy times for sure, you know, it's really inspiring what we're doing across, you know, in this industry, across this, you know, dedicated and great partnerships with NASA, commercial, you know, providers and international teams. It's just really exciting for the program, and we're really proud to be part of it.
All right. Well, again, that was Phil Dempsey. Phil, thank you so much for dialing in. And Phil's the manager of the Vehicle Integration Office from the International Space Station Program for NASA. Thank you, Phil.
All right. Thanks. You have a good evening.
You too. All right. We are very close now to the nose cone being open. Looks like it just has a few more degrees to go. And we'll stand by and wait for confirmation on the loops to hear that again. Once we get the nose cone open, it'll be time for Dragon to reorient itself to maneuver for some forward bulkhead Draco checkouts, and then that'll be the last thing we do in the next couple of minutes before it's time to start those phasing burns. And as I was talking through there, we actually just heard the nose cone is now open. So Dragon already stepping through its automated sequence, getting ready to do the checkouts of those forward bulkhead thrusters. And then once those are ready, we'll be set up and good to go and ready to do our phasing burns. So really great to have a Dragon back on orbit, the 27th resupply mission to the International Space Station on its way, a safe, healthy Dragon, bringing over 6,000 pounds of cargo. With the nose cone open, Draco checkouts underway, that's going to do it for us here in Houston. We'll be back on Thursday morning to take you through the final moments of Dragon's approach and docking to the International Space Station. But with